Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of Stardew Valley. And in today's episode, it is the day of the Big Egg Festival, so we're going to do a little bit of festivaling, which is pretty cool. Do need to water the crops first, though. That needs to get done. It's a daily chore. Very important. Don't want our crops and stuff to die on us. Also, looks like we have a ton of parsnips that are ready to be harvested, which is good. That'll save us a little bit of time in watering. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try and kind of limit the amount of crops that I replant. So let's grab all these parsnips. And we're just not gonna replant anything in this area. I also kinda wanna revamp the shape of my farm a little bit, just to get it kinda better organized and all that kinda stuff too. So that's kinda the plan. We'll go ahead and plant or water all of our remaining crops. There we go. Almost done. Still using up like half of my energy for the whole day, which is a little ridiculous. But that's okay. So I'm thinking, now, the egg festival is from 9 to 2, and if I remember correctly, at the end of the egg festival, essentially what's going to happen is the day will be over. So I think the best use of my time here is probably to do a bunch of work, do a bunch of tree chopping and stuff like that, because we're trying to get to 300 wood, so that we can repair something in the village. So I think the best thing to do is probably going to be to basically chop down trees and stuff until I really don't have a whole lot of energy left. And then once that's done, then we'll head over to the egg festival unless we run out of time in the day. But we have a little while, so I think that's going to be, I think that's probably the way to go, for a lot of different reasons. It doesn't make sense to waste like pretty much a full day's worth of energy just because there's a festival. So the festival has now started. It's 9 o'clock, but we still have a couple hours to actually get over there. And we definitely don't want to miss it, because I think we can get a pretty cool reward if we win the egg hunt. So it's all good. Let's see, how are we doing for wood? We've got 36 pieces. Still have a lot to go. Let's just chop all that stuff down. I think we'll chop down maybe like two more trees. And then we'll head to the egg. Actually, I don't know if I have the energy to chop down two more trees. Maybe we'll just take down some of these little logs. That might be a better idea. Just the little guys. Just take those down. A little bit here, a little bit there. There we go. So we got ourselves 57 wood today. It's a start. It's definitely something. And we're pretty much out of energy now, so let's just put all this away, like so. We now are up to 175 wood total. Definitely getting closer to our goal, but let's head over to the egg festival and check that out. Let's see. And we'll kind of keep an eye out on our way for anything we could forage. I'm not seeing anything. So to the egg festival we go. There we go. And here we are at the egg festival. I've got 1,000 gold, and I think we should probably buy some strawberry seeds, maybe, because these are basically 8 days to mature, which means we'll get a couple harvests out of them. I think that's probably worth it. Let's just go ahead and buy like 10 of those, and we'll plant those and do something with them. And then there's all the villagers here we can talk to. Hello. Hello, everybody. Elliot. I'm thinking Leia is probably going to be the one that I'm going to go for as far as searching for a bride. Little secret about me. I've always been a sucker for redheads, not going to lie. And she just seems kind of the most down to earth. She seems, I don't know, she seems like the one that I'd want to marry. She just seems like the best choice, in my opinion. Leia. There's other people. There's, do you think everyone's ready for the egg hunt? No, I want to talk with everyone first. There's also, what's her name? The blonde. Her, down here. I forget what her name is off the top of my head. But she's kind of mean. Like, I don't think she's really good wife material. And then there's Maru. Maru's just not very attractive. And then there's Abigail. And Abigail I kind of like. Abigail's all right, but she's kind of a loner, you know? I mean, I think Leia's kind of the obvious choice. So we'll talk with all of the villagers. Hello, Pam. Put something nice in the punch. Wonder what that was. I have a pretty good idea. Is there any more food? Not a lot. Who are you? Gus! Interesting. And then we got the kids. Okay. I think we're ready for the egg hunt. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Where is the mayor? Mayor, hello. Yes, let's start the egg hunt. All right, here we go. Basically, what we need to do is get as many eggs as we can and hope we get them faster than everybody else. So we're gonna start kind of looking around the annual spring egg hunt. You'll see them kind of peeking around all over the place. We'll just have to be kind of careful and try and grab as many as we possibly can. Are we ready? Yes, I am absolutely ready. Let's go. Let the egg hunt begin. Here we go. Let's kind of keep an eye out. There's an egg over here. I see one there. Let's grab that. That's two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Oh, I can't get back there, I don't think. I don't think it's possible. Oh no, I'm quickly running out of time. Seven. Eight. Eight. There we go. Nine. Can I get behind the house? Oh, I can. Awesome. So that's nine. Ten. 11. And, okay, so we got 11 eggs in the time limit. Hopefully that'll be enough to secure us the victory. That's double digits. I'm feeling good about it. We'll see. Look at all these eggs. Now, if only I could get you kids to pick up litter this efficiently, we'd have the cleanest town this side of Gem Sea. And now, the winner of this year's egg hunt. It is... Welsknight! Yay, we won! What did we win? Here's your prize, enjoy! We got a straw hat! Okay, cool! Well, that's it for this year's Egg Festival, thanks for coming, everyone! Excellent! So, we won the egg hunt! That's pretty cool, that's pretty awesome! Good stuff! And now it's super late at night. Let's go ahead and put on our super awesome straw hat. Now we're a true farmer. And... ooh, we don't have a whole lot of energy left. I'd like to plant my strawberries tonight before it becomes too late. So that's five. And then four, five. I think we'll be able to water. I mean, it's only 10 crops. So we're going to be a little bit tired. Oh, man. I'm starting to get exhausted. Starting to feel exhausted, but I'm not actually exhausted yet, so I think I am okay to go to sleep. Yes, let's sleep for the night. So, we leveled up farming, watering can proficiency, hoe proficiency. We can now craft a stone fence, a mayonnaise machine, and a sprinkler. Awesome. We got 665 gold for selling all of our parsnips that we harvested. And we planted 10 strawberries today, which is pretty fantastical. That's pretty awesome. All right, let's see. So, initiation. We need to enter into the Adventurer's Guild. Deeper in the mines, level 40 in the mines. Raising animals, build a coop. Okay, so those are our quests. We do have full energy, which is great. We do need to water all of our crops, though. So let me get that done, guys, and I'll come back to you in just a minute. Alright guys, I am back. So, we got all the stuff watered. I do want to go ahead and start smelting up some coal, or some copper into copper bars, because we're going to need that. I'm also thinking... oh, not the watering can, that's not what I meant to do. That's okay. I'm thinking we have this parsnip. I might actually eat that parsnip, just so we can chop down the trees, because I really would like to get to 300 wood today. That's going to be a little bit of a process, though. We're gonna need a lot of wood. Because I'm only at like 175 or so. And we're gonna need a lot more than that for what I need 300 altogether so that I can repair a bridge and get a load of money, because there's a great harvesting spot that you can get to, or foraging spot, I should say, that you can get to by repairing that bridge. Let's just kind of clear out some of this. Now, one nice thing about the scythe is that it doesn't actually use any energy, which is pretty cool. But I think we should be good. I'm probably gonna have to eat that parsnip. This will be three trees that we'll have chopped down. There we go. What are we at for wood? 52. We might have to finish that tomorrow. Maybe. I don't know. It'll be close. Let's chop down this pine tree. I don't know. Yeah. I really don't think I'm gonna have enough energy to get everything today. I might have to finish it tomorrow, which wouldn't be the end of the world. That wouldn't be a really big deal. Let's go ahead and eat our parsnip so we can at least finish chopping down this tree. Ooh, that did not restore as much as I thought it was going to. Although, one thing I didn't think about is we can craft food. So maybe what we should do is head back into here. Oh, we got a copper bar done. Let's light up another one. There we go. Maybe what we should do is make ourselves some energy bars so that we can finish this chore. And have enough wood. So we need acorns, pine cones, and maple seeds, and that will let us craft these field snacks. Now, before I can make any more, I need more pine cones. So I'm thinking what we should probably do is focus on chopping down pine trees, because they have a chance of dropping more pine cones when you chop them down. Not really seeing a whole lot more pine trees, though. Here we go. There's a bunch over here. Let's get rid of that guy, and let's level this pine tree. Ooh. Field snack is needed. I'm about to pass out from sheer exhaustion. There we go. And we're still about 50 wood short of our goal, so we're gonna have to keep going. Two trees might be enough, and we did get another pine cone, so I can make another field snack if I need to, which is definitely good as well. Let's chop you down. There we go. And there was another pine cone, so that's enough for two more field snacks, which is great. And there we go. How much wood is that? 35. Still short. Man. Terrible. That's all right. I think that's probably good there. Let's see. What else do we need to clear out? I kind of want to clear this guy out. This tree right here. And actually, I think before we do that, oh, and these are great too. You can see these planted, and you can pick them up and get more acorns. You can do the same for, pine cones. You'll find them just kind of planted in the ground. You just take a hoe and dig them up, and it works out pretty well. Let's see. Oh, and you know what? I put my coal, or my, copper back in the chest over here. Let's see here. There we go. Let's just put all that in there. We still need... Oh, we need one more piece of wood. Okay, that's totally doable. Let's grab this stuff as well. Let's make a couple more field snacks. And I think we should be in good shape. So let's chop down one more tree. I'm thinking this guy is the one that's the most in our way. We obviously need to clear out enough land that we can, you know, do what we need to do. There we go. And there it is. All right, so we've got our 300 wood that we need. And grab that copper bar. Light up another. I want to make sure that I've got 5 copper bars lying around, so if we get a day where it's going to rain twice in a row, we can go ahead and repair... we can upgrade our watering can. I think that's going to be really important. Let's see. So we'll put all of this stuff. I'll just leave this on me, I think. What do I not need? I don't really need... Well, you know what? This is fine. Just like this. We're good to go. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to head down to the beach. And I think the fastest way to get there is probably through the southern exit to the farm down here. Let's see. Do I have a path? I do have a path cleared out. Nice. I'm so pro. Okay, so let's see here. Beach should be like over this way, I think. And we'll kind of keep our eyes out for things that we might be able to forage. Not really seeing a whole lot. Ooh, what is this? That's not something I can actually dig up. Never mind, it's a decoration. Just kidding. Okay. So, to the beach we go. We've got our 300 wood. Oh, I didn't actually bring my wood with me. And here I was saying I was so pro. Apparently I'm not pro at all. I'm such a noob. Go me. Okay, so let's run back home. I'll grab my 300 wood and I'll meet you at the beach. Alright guys, here we are at the beach, and it is time to do a little bit of area improvement. So we've got this bridge here that's out, and we can use 300 pieces of wood to fix it. Now what's awesome about this area, now that it's fixed, you will find over here all sorts of good stuff to harvest. Like this coral right here, for example, which is pretty valuable, and it will respawn over time. Now, it doesn't look like there's a whole lot here right now, which is kind of unfortunate. Looks like, yeah, we really didn't do so hot with that, but that's all right. It did, we do have it unlocked, so we can always come back there and look for more valuable stuff, and it's a great place to harvest. It's free money. Looks like the fishing shop just closed, so we'll have to hold off on selling that stuff. I suppose we could just dump it in our exports bin, though. That might be the best thing to do. In fact, I think that's what we will do. So we can get a little bit of money, but I think that coral alone sells for like 75 gold. Just lying around, and you'll find a pretty significant amount of it. So you can get a lot of gold down there really quickly if you do it, you know, if you, especially over time with foraging. So it's well worth it. It's well worth it to unlock that. And I think it's actually a pretty good fishing spot as well. But I think we are good to go. We got the egg festival done, we got the bridge unlocked, and all is well. But it's getting late, my energy is low, and I think, guys, that is pretty much gonna do it for me for this episode. So, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.